I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making taco meatloaf. And this is a recipe that I mentioned in our previous video because that's where I made taco seasoning. And that seasoning recipe came from Arritta Morris, who is the food columnist in our newspaper. And she also had a taco meatloaf to use the seasoning in. So that's what I'm going to show you. I have a large bowl. And into that bowl, I put one egg, and I've used a mixer to beat that until it's really foamy. We're going to add 1/2 cup of sour cream. Also, we're adding some salsa. And this is what I chose, but there are a lot of choices for salsa. This is Chi-Chi's restaurant style, and it's medium. And we need 1/3 cup. So if you normally add ketchup or something like that, this takes the place of that, but it's going to be a little more Mexican, a little more spicy. And to turn up the spice, we have our taco seasoning that was just made. And what we're going to use, I've gotten out here, you may use 3 to 4 tablespoons. You can see, measuring it, 1 tablespoon, about that much. And I chose to go with 4. Because Rick and I like something like this, very spicy, but you may choose something less. Next, we're going to grind in a little salt, and that is because there was salt in our mix right here, but it was to give a little salt, but allow you to vary the amount of salt that you put in any dish. So this is going to need more because we're going to have some ground beef. Next comes some tortilla chips, and these are just crushed. They should look about like this. This is 1 cup. It's like having breadcrumbs or something like that in your meatloaf, but it's more south of the border style. Here we have 1/2 cup of finely shredded cheddar cheese. And then the essential here, ground beef for the meatloaf. This is 1.5 pounds of ground beef. So now I just need to get this all mixed together and form it into a loaf. Here we have our mix of our taco meatloaf, and I've been just using this spoon and trying to get it very well mixed together. It's looking good and smelling good already. What I'm going to do is put it in a standard size loaf pan. And I've put a little bit of aluminum foil in here. The foil is sometimes helpful in getting the loaf out of the pan. So we'll fill this and flatten off the top. And then one step that I'm going to advise you to do is to place this loaf in the refrigerator for 1 hour before you bake it. And the reason for that is that it has those crunchy chips, and if you let it sit for a while, those chips will absorb the flavors of the ground beef and the salsa and everything that we're putting in here. So they won't be just crunchy at the end of cooking, which I don't think they would be anyway, but you can make this better flavored by letting it sit in the refrigerator for 1 hour. So after that 1 hour, I plan to get it out, and I will put it in the oven at 350 degrees. And I'm going to let it bake 1 hour. And I'm going to bring the foil up over the top so it won't have a tendency to burn on the top. And then later in the cooking, I will open it up and let it get browned off. This is what it looks like as it goes to the refrigerator. And I will come back after it comes out of the oven. Here's our taco meatloaf. It's just fresh out of the oven. I baked it for 1 hour at 350 degrees, and I actually took these parts that were folded at the beginning like that. I brought them out for the last 15 minutes so this could brown a little on the top. Now, what I plan to do is to let this rest for a while. Remove it from the Pyrex dish and place it over here and let it rest on a cutting board. Here is our finished taco meatloaf on a platter. So this is the way you would serve it. And I have my place set up over here with my iced tea, which I'm looking forward to. And I want to taste the meatloaf for you. Here at the end, I'll get a couple of pieces. And let's try this end piece. It's very soft, great texture. Very spicy, but not overly. Just the right amount of salt. Enough for me to even sort of taste the salt, but to recognize it's not too much. I love the flavor of it. It's such a great treat when you're used to just the same kind of meatloaf. So if you make meatloaf a lot and you use the same recipe every time, you probably will get tired of it occasionally. And if you try something like this, it's like a whole new dish. It's really good. I hope you enjoy this recipe.